And I am filled with admiration for her sense of commitment. She is one of the most dedicated and the most meticulous editors I've met. You never go back on your deadline either. You make sure no one else does. So she runs a tight ship. And I know that she goes through every comma and every semicolon. She makes sure the captions are in place. And she gives hell to anybody who doesn't
toe
the editorial line.
That's what a good editor does.
Yeah,
thank you. I try and give them hell, but I'm not good at that, so even there I'm learning.
But this book has been the culmination of a dream. And I have known about this dream for a long time. And it's interesting that she got so many people to participate in the dream. And so much of her fantasy, which you will see in the book, and those of you who have had a chance to look at it. And we see her in various avatars that I'm sure a lot of ladies may fantasize about, but would dare not actually see that happen in quite such a graphic and literal way. So you have Sangeeta as Cleopatra. You have Sangeeta as, I think, Maharani Gayatri Devi.
Yeah.
You have Sangeeta as Umrao Jan. And various top designers who have been a part of this fantasy. It's also wonderful that at an informal chat at our home, which was talking about the making of the book, and what she had in mind for it, and it was a very ambitious plan, and I said, this is fantastic if you can actually achieve it and make it happen, because it's an expensive book to produce. It's an expensive book to spend so much time, energy to put together, and to have it launched at what would be a dream venue for a lot of writers is something that's really a tribute to your determination and the fact that you have a lot of people who clearly love you and are happy to be a part of this event as I am. I'm delighted, proud, happy, and may you go on from this book to many more books. A lot of people who you've written about in this book from your various interviews with them, I'm sure have enriched your life on so many different levels, and that comes through in the book. And I'm sure in your own unique way, you have enriched theirs. So I wish you all the very best, my dear Sangeeta, and
so the journey has obviously been pretty long. It's been about 2 decades, but I think in two.
Attitude, simple living and high thinking. Back in the mid 90s, Sangeeta was more than happy choosing that, having grown up around a family that nourished her dreams.
When I started out with Society, it was the mid 90s, and my boss was Seema Verghese. And she noticed that foreign brands are coming into the country, so we're going to have to up the game, and we're going to have to invest in better photography and better, you know, just work on better dynamics, put together a stronger package. So we did this very bold cover. It was an anniversary issue in 1994, and we worked with very talented people like Suresh Natarajan, a photographer, and TV Narayanan, who is from an advertising background.
A lover of Indian myth as a child. Most of her fictional writing and her painting stems from that vast font of gods and goddesses she felt so familiar with.
As a writer, I think I resonate with Saraswati, not only because she gives you a sense of peace and a sense of acceptance and a sense of...
Somehow, I could pull it out of my hat. I don't know how, but I could do it. So I said, you know, then maybe this is a God-given talent. You know? Yeah, thanks.
Good question there.
Yeah, Sangeeta, hi.
Hi.
You're really beautiful.
beautiful, you write very well.
Thank you.
You actually paint beautiful paintings with words. So my question to you specifically is, this book is about your various encounters along the years, and I'm sure it's going to be a gorgeous reading, and I'm looking forward to it. When's the next book coming?
Well, let me get over this one first. Thank you for those lovely words, Sohail. I just hope you do give me proper feedback on the book.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Any more questions? Ninas and I were college buddies.
We have a question at the back.
Why you categorize as a coffee table book? Because then it has a restricted readers audience. And the audience. So okay. Because by the content, I think that it has a wider audience and the readers. So you should have categorized as something else. So it has a wider audience.
So what we were hoping to do is, this is just like a vision that I had, because I felt these stories are very visually rich. But if tomorrow a penguin wants to pick it up and do a paperback, I'm all for it. I totally agree with what you're saying. I think that stories would, you know, be good for everyone. Thank you.
Mention, so will you in the future will you be like to have an encounter with any of the poor guys who are really making some big, riots in their life?
I totally want to explore a new demographic, to be very honest, because how many times am I going to meet the same people over and over again? But obviously one needs to know what the quote-unquote poor guys are up to. And it's going to be a bit of a challenge for me to get out of this groove and get into that groove. But if you can help me, I'm more than willing to meet people. In fact, I think when the whole IT wave was coming over the country, there were lots of new people, lots of fresh blood that was overnight doing startups, and Silicon Valley must be full of such interesting people. So sure, I would love to meet people of different walks of life, always. And a lot of people in my book were not always rich. So what's inspiring is how they got from where they were to where they are now. To me, that was part of the story. Thank you.
Okay, all these persons who...
I'm here, both of you. Thank you.
Thank you.